Definitely, it will be useful for your 10th standard SSC board exam, and it will be very good for you. And I will try to explain it very properly and according to my knowledge, according to whatever the said by the teacher. Remember, students, that when I'm explaining this the poem, especially I research about the poet also and the poem also, what exactly the meaning is there, what is not given into the text. So whatever the meaning you are getting from the digest or other sites, so please compare this, all this. It not means that I'm the perfect in this and I'm completely, whatever I'm saying, this completely truth, completely fixed only. It is not like this. Many digests, many books and many reference books have the different meaning sometimes, and the references also having, you can find out. So please refer all the things. Today we are going to see the most one important poem, that is Custard, that you see here. What is the poem? In this, we are going to see this poem. The Tale of Custard the Dragon. This is the poem which is composed by the Ogden Nash. He is a very important poet in British poetry. And he talk about the specially about the social society. What exactly into the society, that is explained into this poem, where some animals are representing the part of the society. Okay, it's very simple one ballad type of poem. Already I told you the ballad, what is the poem. In 9th standard we have seen the legend of the Northland. This one ballad we have seen. Ballad is a folk tale specially told for the bravery or any person. But this is a type of ballad which is talking about animals, and where the custard is one dragon. The tale of Custard the Dragon, the tale of that particular animal which is very important, which is the hero of our this poem. So if you are not subscribed to the channel, first subscribe it and like the video if you like it especially. So let's start the poem. What is there? The introduction of the poem is that this poem is written in the style of ballad, the song of the poem that tells the story of one particular person, particular animal or particular one. You must be familiar with the ballad that narrate the tale of courage or heroism, glorious life of the particular person or particular saint or particular one. That is a glorious life or heroism, courage of this one. This poem is humorous ballad close to the parody. Okay, parody is what? Now the parody is something commenting, something with a negative or opposite ideas of the ballad, where we are, when we are talking about the humorous, when we are talking about the heroism of one person, and in the next one we make it humorous. It is something laughable. Sometimes it is giving, we are not encouraging the idea of that particular person, or we are not happy with the heroism of that person. It is a parody. Parody is opposite about the courage and the heroism. Now see this poem. In rhythmic way we have to read it. Here the first stanza is given. Belinda live in little White House. Now see, White House represent here as one Senate or one place where the specially the main person of the nation lives. Okay, White House refer to the American White House, we can say. But here White House is what? It is the main place, capital place of the thing, of the particular region, where the Belinda represent the president, or Belinda represent the highest class, who is the owner of all these animals, who is the owner of this region. Okay, and she have the some animals, she have some animals in her house as her pet, which is the first one is the little black kitten, and second one is little gray mouse. Now here little kitten and the mouse, both are opposite ideas here used, and both are opposite animals lives here. Kitten is always not, she's it is not living on one place, it is always roaming from one place to another place. This is second one is a mouse, which is always not live on one place. The third one is the little yellow dog and the little red dragon. These are the four animals she kept as a pet in her house, and these animals are representing four classes of the society. This is you must remember. Here the kitten is one type of part of the society, one class of the society, little grey mouse, which is also one, and the little dog, this is also represent for the society. And the little red dragon, it is the fourth class, lowest class of the society. We can say that this is the middle class of the society. Which have Relio Trulio. Relio Trulio, here it is one type of figure of speech. You have to find out it. Already I made the one figure of speech on that. One video on the figure of speech. You have to find out Relio and Trulio. Now see, Relio and Trulio, these words are not into the English. Okay, these are just made for the effect. Just made for the particular effect on of the lines. Relio means here real and Trulio. This true and real. I am telling real and truth. That is the word specially, but really and truly this word are modified to make the more effect on the readers. So little pet dragon, one that dragon, really I am telling you, truly I am telling you that little pet dragon, that was a red dragon. These four animals, now see what happened. Here the characteristics of given sub animals. So second stanza we came to know that now the name of the little black kitten was Ink. The name of little black kitten, it is named as Ink. Okay, the second one is there, the little gray mouse, she called a Blink. She has given the name to the little gray mouse, that is Blink, Ink and Blink. Third one is the yellow dog, has name as a mustard, which is powerful, which is very strong in fighting. See, the Ink, Blink and the mouse. Blink is what, because it is always running away and it is not seen properly. Then third name, but the dragon was a coward. Now see, most powerful animal is a dragon according to our knowledge. Most powerful and most dangerous animal is a dragon, and having a lot of features, lot of dangerous features inside the in the dragon, but still the dragon is a coward, and therefore she is telling it is a custard. Custard, coward. Custard means it's very not very useful, not very testless person. Is very testless. And therefore, what are the names are given there? So in third stanza we came to know that the custard, the dragon had a big sharp teeth. The features and the characteristics of the custard dragon has given here first. Sharp teeth, it is having, which can be very dangerous for like one, and it has a spike on the top of him and skull underneath. On his body there are the spikes. Now we know very well spikes are what the means. Most of the students are making the spike on their hair, so they are like looking like a dragon or like a crocodile. It is having the spikes on the body, scale and underneath, it's having the under his skin, it has the spikes, which will be very when it will become the angry and the spikes are come out. That is the speciality of the dragon, and its body skin is not very delicate like a human being. It's a very one toughest body body skin of the dragon. Mouth like a fireplace, chimney for a nose. Its mouth, because we know that the dragon is putting the fire, dragon is out the fire, breathe the fire, and it is the place of fire, its mouth, because it is throwing the fire out his mouth. And the chimney, when it is a fire in his mouth, that in the nose, when it is taking the breath and out breath and in breath, that time the smoke is come out and smoke is come inside, that is a chimney. Therefore it is telling us a chimney for the nose. Julio, Trulio, dagger in his toes, and in their toes the nails are like daggers, like a knife, a great knife, which can be very dangerous. And still these are the features of the dragon, which can be very dangerous and maybe possible that if the dragon came to know that it has this type of features, like it is already I told you that this dragon is compared with the middle class society, and the middle class society have such type of things. It has the great features about the society, which having the power to change the nation, to change the society, and still it is not having, it is unaware about their features. French Revolution, Russian Revolution, and even the Indian freedom movement also is the example of this one, because the middle class families, middle class people had took the great part and they changed the complete scenario of the nation, and only because of them. And therefore, this truly true. Fourth stanza is telling that Belinda was a brave as a barrel full of beers. Belinda is full of, she's a brave one, no doubt. Full of beers, barrel full of beer. It is the comparison between her, and it is, as we can say, simile. Barrel full of beer, when beer it is, where it is energetic one. She is also energetic like a beer. Beer is here, that wine or like a, when we say that this, like a drugs. And when she's, when the person is taking the drug, you know very well, when the person is drunkard or having the drugs, it has become a lot of powerful. And it, this person feels that he is very greatest person, and he's, nobody is there in the world who can defeat to him. And the same here, the Belinda is thinking about herself. Belinda is like, oh, that great one. And the ink blink chase lion down the stair. And ink blink, both are very powerful, very, like they are saying, they are very powerful. They can chase to the lion also. The lion also will run away when lion will see them. And when they are taking, they are chasing to the lion, lion also will go out in front of them there. And up to where? Down the stair. They are chasing to each other, playing. Mustard was as brave as a tiger in the rack. Mustard was like, it is a brave, like a tiger. And these are the features. But the most important, the custard cried for a nice cage. This one custard is not so much powerful, and therefore it is only finding out the safe place where we can safely. Now see here, ink blink are, I told you the ink blink and mustard, these are the one particular that ink here, we can say the writers, remember one ink, why the ink is given there, writers, those are writing the pages, those are writing the writer, writing something, blink, those are researchers, and this one mustard, they are the high qualities one. They believe that they are most powerful person, and blink is Belinda is a kingship, what you are talking, kingship or the arrest, that bureaucrats, we can say. This there, Belinda is full of brave. She is telling the political leaders, we know very well they how to give the speeches on them. Ink and blink, they are chasing to the lions on the pages only. The mustard having the power, but the custard is cried. And when the middle class families are just want to save place, they just fighting for the petrol, then what the prices are there, the gold, and that only they are satisfied with this one. But about the nation, they are not thinking, miss custard, they are like a particular safe place they want on their side. And this is a thought by the Ogden Nash. In fifth stanza, we came to know about Belinda tickle him, always taunting. She ticked him unmercifully, and when she is tickled, she is making the lot of comments on him that you are useless, you are like this and that all. Many things as our parents are telling to us every day. We have the experience about this. And unmerciful, she don't have any mercy about ink, blink, mustard. They rudely call him Percival. They are calling it Percival. Percival means useless or coward. And such people, they are calling this one. Ink, blink, and mustard, they are talking always on their status. Talking about its mind, which is not prepared for the fighting and this. They all sat laughing in the little red wagon. And when they are sitting there, ink, blink, and mustard, both, all three animals are sitting on the outside on the cart, on the wagon. They always talk about the custard, they are talking about the dragon, they are talking about how she, it is very coward, and see, sitting into the safe place and finding the safe place and not coming for the fighting, not coming outside that. Tullio Tullio, cowardly dragon. Tullio Tullio, cowardly dragon. About them, it is telling. They are telling about the coward. They are telling about such things about the dragon. And the next stanza is telling the Belinda giggled till she shook the house. One time happened, the Belinda giggled till she shook the house. And it is she's also talking about, and she's taking the whole house very on her head. And Blink said, Vic. Blink said, she's telling, she's also, when Belinda started to beating that dragon, started to giving a lot of words to the dragon, that Blink, a small mouse, it is also said that it's Vic, which is giggling for the mouse. And it is giggling, it is talking about the mouse. Mouse is also talking many things to the dragon. Ink and Mustard lewdly ask him age. Or Ink or Mustard, both are asking him age. Why they are asking their age? Because the custard is very age one, and it is when it is living into the into the safe place, it is finding out the safe place, hiding himself and away from the others, not taking any part in the arguments and not taking the part into the fighting and nothing. Therefore, they are asking, why you are behaving like a child? Therefore, your age is really like a child. Is you are childish one. They are talking like this. And so, when Custer cried for the nice safe place, when they are, this, the Ink and the Mustard, they are talking about like this. In next 1-7 stanza, we came to know, suddenly, and very suddenly, one incident is there in that place, in that house, in the White House. What happened? Once the Mustard heard a nasty sound, nasty, very dangerous sound, very different sound, which was unusual sound, which was not regular one, and Mustard growled, feared about, started fearing about what type of sound is there, and look around. The dog, which was like a tiger, it was started looking outside, what is the sound, and it is completely feared about. Which was telling like a tiger, which is particularly specialized like a tiger, characterized like a tiger, now it is very feared about. And what about? Meowch, cried Ink, and oh, cried Belinda. Ink, which was very chasing to the lion, which this also said the meowch and start away with the flying and run away and hide herself somewhere. Oh, Belinda also, which was very brave, energetic, powerful, this also became silent in this. For there was a parrot climbing in the window. One. Now here, window is not a word, window is there, but for making the rhyming scheme, to keep the rhyming scheme, Belinda, window. This for poet has written this word, poet has made one change in that word, and this is a poetic license for the poet according to T.S. Eliot. So there, one parrot is entering into the house, pistol in his left hand, one pistol is there, pistol in right, both hand it is having the pistols, gun, and he held his teeth cut last bright. And he started laughing towards the house, to looking at the people, those living into the house. His beard was black and one leg was wood. Now see, pirate of the sea, we have seen and we know very well the what is the particular character, particular appearance of the pirate. That one, like it is, it has one black beard, then one teeth, and having the one golden teeth, one eye is gone away, one leg is broken, and it is having the wood, having the guns, cap on his head. It was clear that the pirate mean no good. When it started laughing, and it is, he came from the window. Okay, means what? It is not a good sign for all. The decision, whatever the directed by the pirate, whatever the said by the, what is the appearance? What the appearance of the parrot came, he came from the window first thing and he started laughing. Means what? Nothing was good in his mind. He wanted to kill anyone. He wanted to loot the house. Something was very bad decision has taken by the parrot, and nothing is good in his mind. His mind is going the wrong way, and therefore it was a clearly sign that a pirate is not very good. So Belinda paled, she became the very pale one, passive one, and started cried, help, help, for help. Now, who could be help to the Belinda? Either Ink, Blink, Mustard or Custard. Four animals were this was a kingship. When the problem come to the nation, the first political leaders and the place, a kingship started help for this. But a Mustard fled with terrible help. That Mustard, which was calling like a tiger, started flying, fled away from the place. Ink tickled down to the bottom of the household. That Ink hid herself somewhere inside the one household place, in the kitchen or somewhere. She's hid herself. The little mouse Blink strategically mouse hole. Blink also went into the mouse hole. That is especially the place of its, and it is also gone away. But remaining one, that is the dragon, which was finding the safe place. Now on the way, the difficulty is on the family. But up jump Custard, and jump came inside the Belinda and the parrot. It's them snarling like an engine. Now it has become very angry, and in that anger it started firing. It started outing the fire from his mouth, and like clash is a tail like iron in the dungeon, and it's become the like iron. Its tail became very like a furnace, become like a very red one, and it is like a become the iron, and it's strong become. And with clatter and the clank and jingling squirm, it started very angered one, and clank, jingling, squirm, clattered, started snoring, and all these changes came into the Custard. He went at the pirate like a robin at the worm, and its face to the dragon, face towards the pirate, and therefore, like a robin. Here, the pirate gap at the Belinda's dragon. Pirate and the Belinda, between them, it stand up, it is a blade arm and throw herself and gulp some grog from his pocket flagon. Now see, the pirate is standing in front of the Belinda, and middle now the dragon came. So, pirate also become very afraid about it. Pirate also want to take some action. And in that action, pirate has took some bullets from his pocket, and it's put up into the gun, into the pistol, and fired two bullets on the dragon. But they didn't hit, because the body of the dragon is become like a iron, and therefore there is no any effect on the dragon. There is no any effect on the dragon's body. It's become already like iron, so that bullet could not make any effect on the body of the Custard, and the Custard gobbled him every bite. When after the two bullets, the dragon has took that person and started eating, and gobbled it, and they swallow, and each and every bite it is very dangerous. Bite to bite it is started to chewing that pirate, and killed that person. Belinda embraced him. Now Belinda embraced him, Mustard licked him, and therefore licked is no one mourn for is the pirate victim. Nobody has shown any mercy for the pirate, because it was a victim. It was already criminal. Already, that pirate wanted to kill the people. So nobody has taken any effect on this. No one mourned for his Ink, Blink in a glee did pirate, and they become very happiest one on that, because it was killed around the dragon that ate the pirate, and they started to roaming around the pirate, and what they are telling to all. But presently up spoke little Mustard. Mustard has told that I had been twice as brave if I hadn't been fluttered. I was fluttered there because I just flustered, but I'm twice brave than the dragon. I am more brave. But what happened? That time I fluttered and I went there. And up the spoke ink and up the blink. Blink and the ink both tell like the same words. We would have been three times as brave. You are two times, or we are the three times brave than the dragon. But what? Custer, I quite agree. Custer said that I agree with your opinion. Whatever you are telling is right. You are the twice brave than me, and you are the thrice braver than me. Everybody is brave than me. I am not very brave one. I am very, very common person, common man. And therefore, there is no news. In the 14th sons of Belinda Teal still live in her little white house with her little black kitten and little gray mouse and her yellow dog and her little dragon wagon and her Lirio Trulio little pet dragon. Still she is living in the same house with the same condition, and that is how the dragon has killed the parrot. When the problem came on the family, dragon has solved the problem, and on that problem time all that run away, those are talking very loudly in the same nation also and the family also. What happened? The people, those are talking that the family is, I'm running the family, I'm the main person, only due to that we are, it is there. So when the problem comes, this all people are run away. They are not staying for the solving the problem. They are not taking any type of responsibility at the moment. But the dragon has taken one, the person who is always like this. Belinda is as brave as a barrel full of beers. She is the one. Ink and Blink chase the lion down the stair. Mustard is brave as a tiger in the race. And the Custer keeps crying for the nice safe place. The same condition is as again started. This is like a common person. What after the French Revolution? Nothing was done. Only the changes. Only the kingship has took place on the democracy. The replaced with the democracy. That only the changes happened in the French Revolution. In the Russian Revolution, the kingship has replaced with the communism. The China the same, and Indian the same also. Only we have changed the government. Nothing we have changed. Everything is same like this only. So what? That the dragon. Thinking about the poem, who are the characters in the poem? Very easiest one. List the names. Why the Custer and nice safe place? Why the dragon called a cowardly dragon? We have Belinda tickle him, she tickle him mercifully. You have to remember that only the worldly, the whatever the word meanings are given here, what is the poetic meaning is there. Don't write anything. I just given you the idea about the poem, whatever the poem has written by the Ogden Nash, in what the situation was in his time. He just explained the moment, explained the thing at his time. Poet employ many poetic devices in the poem. For example, clash is a tail like iron in the dungeon. The poetic device. Poetic device means, already I told you, this is a figure of speeches. You remember, you must remember this one. It's a simile. Can you find out such things? You have to find out many things from this poem, and many things are there. Metaphor, then already I told you, 3-4 particular, regular figure of speeches are there. You have to find out from the poem. Then read the stanza three again, and know how the poet described the appearance of the dragon. That's very easy one. Can you find out the rhyme scheme, 2 and 3 stanza? Yes, very easy one. Rhyming scheme very new. When last two words are the same in the 2 lines or 3 lines. Okay, these are the rhyming scheme. There are 3 types of rhyming scheme: middle rhyming, initial rhyming, and the last rhyming. Here we are talking about the last rhyming. On the last two words, the pronunciation at least should be the same one. Writers use words to give us a picture of image without actually saying what they mean. Can you trace some image used in the poem? That images, what I told you, this images you have to trace in this poem. Do you find the tale of Custer the Dragon to be a serious or the light-hearted poem? Give reasons support your answer. It is a serious or it is only just a humorous poem? This poem is a ballad form, tell the story. Have you come across any such modern song or lyric that is tell the story? If you know one, tell this, just the collect song as a project. This is your writing skill. You can find it out yourself. In this way, the poem is finished here. And I hope you will understand the poem. And please subscribe. The channel is given here. If you still not subscribe, subscribe the channel. Watch. Thank you for watching this one. And don't visit to my blog, that philoindia.blogspot.com. And I got the channel URL also, that you can find out here, www.youtube.com/c/ingarden, that you can visit here and subscribe anytime. Thank you for all of you. Take care.